As clouds build into the area, we leave way for some showers overnight. Throwing it over now to that satellite and radar composite, we can see clouds that have gradually built in over the past couple hours, but we're just going to see those continue to build in. Maryville already getting some showers, St. Joseph. The next round of showers and thunderstorms is heading our way. Now, that wasn't enough to stop those high temperatures from breaking into the 90s throughout the state of Missouri. Here in St. Joseph, reaching 93 degrees. But our neighbors off to the west in Kansas, a sign of what's to come. Triple digits, 107 degrees was the high temperature over in Wichita. Be sure to stay tuned, though, because I'm going to have more on this incoming hot weather coming up later in the broadcast. Sophia, back. Welcome back. As clouds continue to build their way into the area, we're currently sitting at a high temperature, or current temperature rather, of 86 degrees, working our way down to that dew point, but still staying pretty dry. So we're going to be seeing those clouds continue to rise with those winds staying mild at about 14 miles per hour across the state of Missouri, dipping into some 70s, 72 degrees up in Kirksville, but still staying warm on into Kansas, 90 in Topeka, 93 degrees over in Wichita. So still staying pretty warm from all those clouds and passing showers. Right now, those clouds are staying up to the north into Iowa, following along a pattern of a warm front. Now, for us here in northwest Missouri, we're going to see those clouds continue to build. Maryville already getting some showers and thunderstorms, but St. Joseph, as we work our way off to the west, we see this next patch of showers and thunderstorms about to work its way right on into our area. Now, that warm front that I was talking about has continued to push its way off to the north, but left behind for us on into the start of the work week this large open area. Now, that open area is due to high pressure. High pressure is going to continue to clear that sky, making way for plenty of sunshine. And unfortunately for us, that means tomorrow, triple digits. Now, we're expecting a regular high temperature tomorrow into right at the century mark, which means, though, with those showers and thunderstorms still lingering up to our north, that we do have a chance for that humidity to build, bringing in a heat index for us, making it feel closer to 105 degrees out there. As we work our way into the work week, we see a dip in the jet stream just barely missing us, though, so that's going to make way for high pressure to build in some more of those hot, humid temperatures for us. So I wish I had better news, but it looks like it's going to be another hot week ahead. Overnight, though, we're going to see temperatures drop down to 72 degrees, keeping a mostly cloudy sky and a few passing isolated showers and thunderstorms. For the most part, those are going to work their way into the area through the overnight hours, dissipate before the sun comes up, but still leaving it a chance for some few lingering morning showers and thunderstorms. But for us, that high temperature is going to be hot out there, 100 degrees, with those clouds clearing, making way for plenty of sunshine. Now, as we work our way throughout the work week, we're going to see that hot temperature rise, just barely missing triple digits, though. Clouds build back in for Monday, but then work their way right on out of the area throughout the rest of the work week, giving way to some sunshine and some upper 90 degree temperatures. So while we may not have triple digits on the extended forecast for the work week, we still can't rule out that heat index bumping it up to feel closer to 100 and even 105 degrees out there. So remember to stay hydrated out there.
What I wouldn't do for rain right about now. Yeah, this is, I've gotten used to it, but I don't want to get used to it too much longer.
A little bit of relief, but still not enough to cool us out for the work week.
Oh, well, okay.